Remember that song, No Scrubs? That's TLC right there. Well, it was written by Kandi Burris. She stars on The Real Housewives of Atlanta. And you know her mom, Mama Joyce. Ooh, she is always trending. And Mama Joyce is very vocal about her fiance, Todd, always saying he's a scrub. Mama Joyce is becoming quite the social media sensation because of her choice words. She's always got some controversy. And joining us now to talk about it is always A-List.com editor-in-chief and pop culture guru, Jawn Murray. Jawn, always good to see you. How you doing?
Ain't no mountain high enough to keep me away from you, Liz.
Preach, Jawn. Okay, so first I want to get everyone caught up on the mama drama, and then we'll talk on the other end. Hang on.
This is Mama Joyce. She's Candy's mother. Mama Joyce is not happy that Kandi is engaged to Todd. She says Todd is an opportunist and will take all of Kandi's money. Well, Mama Joyce also says Kandi's friend and assistant Carmen wants to be with Todd. Kandi says that's nonsense. Kandi loves Todd and wants to marry him anyway, but not if Mama Joyce has anything to say about it. Now, Kandi is torn between the man she loves, her close friend, and the most important person in her life, Mama Joyce.
Add water and stir for reality show drama. Jawn, you know, I know that you know Kandi. You actually just talked to her, I believe, right? What does she say about all this? Because this is her mom, her best friend, and her soon-to-be husband.
Well, you know, for a lot of people, this is, you know, viewing pleasure and for entertainment purposes only. But she's really living this in real life. This isn't put on. This isn't scripted. This is her actuality. And so she's really stressed about it. Mama Joyce has not spoken to her in more than a week because Mama Joyce is upset about all the things that people are saying about her in social media and in television commentaries. So she's mad at Kandi because the folks are mad at her, even though she's the one who turned up on television.
And she freaked out on TV right there in this video. That's what has everyone talking today. I want to show you a clip from last night's Real Housewives of Atlanta. This is where Mama Joyce and Kandi's friend go at it at Kandi's sort of bridal fitting. Take a look.
You're acting a fool. You seem like you're acting a fool.
Never get between a woman and her wedge shoe. I mean, Mama Joyce has really gone too far here, in my opinion. What about you?
Oh, absolutely. And here's the thing, you know, I don't know why Mama Joyce is so upset. She's mad at everybody, but she's never liked any of the guys that Kandi has dated. But see, Kandi has a way of dealing with her mom. You know, Kandi may be wearing fiery red hair on TV, but she's not a hothead in real life. It takes a lot to push her to that place. So she takes a very calm and zen approach to her mom, and she would never disrespect her mom. So people are saying, you need to go off on your mama. You need to put your mom in her place. That's not even in Kandi's character. She genuinely loves her mom and knows how to deal with her, but she can't stop her mama for dealing with other people the way she is. And this is all very new. Kandi's been on the show like 6 seasons and her mother's never done any of this before.
And Jawn, everybody has something to say about it. I think they just like the drama, but I gotta tell you, she trended last week for 48 hours and she's trending again today. What is it about this woman that people get so crazy for?
Lynn, how many 60-year-old women do you know trend for 48 hours?
Right.
Mama Joyce is going to end up hosting SNL. Mark my words.
There you go. You heard it here first, Jawn Murray. Thanks so much. We'll see you when the next trending story happens, okay? Well, in the next hour, you're going to hear Kandi's response to all that social media firestorm. That's coming up next.
I already gave my big sexual harassment speech today.
And please refrain from discussing or engaging in any sort of inter-office or finger or sting or eating or even though so many people in this office are begging for it.
So that is a scene from the hit show Arrested Development. He's talking about the office Christmas party. We've all been there, right? Maybe had a few too many, felt a little embarrassed the next day. Even worse when it happens at the holiday office party. Thus, you are then the buzz around the water cooler the next day. I don't know. Have you guys ever had this experience where
truth be told, we're talking about it, but
we're not giving details. So, Jawn, you are willing to go out on the ledge here, I would hope. Have you ever had this happen?
You know, I'm always on my best behavior at the party. Because listen, the holiday Christmas party is not Las Vegas. What happens there does not stay there. It can impact your employment.
That is true. And John, you know, the reason that this all always happens mostly is because of too much booze, right? You have a couple too many cocktails. And Glamour magazine actually found that 60% of people have a really good story about their holiday office party, whether it happened to them. And there are some do's or don'ts that I want to share with you guys.
She's doing a demonstration.
We're going to do a demo. Come with me over here, because we've got some examples of some do's and don'ts so that we can keep you sober at your office party and not get you fired. And this one really surprised me, because don't you guys always think that eating a burger and fries, like, get that grease in you so that it sort of absorbs all the alcohol? Apparently that's not the case. They say that you should have a nice healthy salad. I know that sounds kind of boring, but you should have a lot of starches. That's what helps absorb the alcohol. I can't believe that we're promoting this, but I promise these will be good tips. Also, this surprised me. You should not have carbonated water. You know, vodka sodas, it sounds good and everything, but the carbonation, they say, actually speeds up intoxication. So sorry, folks, stay away from that. Also, they say avoid champagne and dark spirits like whiskey and brandy, also those sweet drinks, because they tend to get you tipsier faster. And then coffee. You know when you have like a cup of coffee because you think that you, do you guys ever do that? You just have a cup of coffee thinking that that would maybe.
I saw in the movies.
Yeah, I see in the movies.
Yeah, here's some coffee.
That's a misconception. They say it just keeps you awake and drunk. So, and so they say, you know, you should actually just maybe stick to wine. John, what do you think? You gonna follow these tips?
Lynn, one of those things are great advice, because you know that dark liquor makes you mad. If you ever watched a clip online of somebody fighting at a party or like a wedding party getting into it, 9 times out of 10 they've had dark liquor. Leave that dark liquor alone. It makes you mad. Drink that at home when you're mad at your spouse.
Okay, there's some good advice there.
I don't know if that's so good.
Yeah, exactly. John, getting a lot of folks in trouble today, always. Thanks for your insight. But maybe you have learned the hard way why this is so important. So tweet me, at LynnBerryTV, some of your craziest holiday party stories. The next hour, we're going to share some of your tweets on the show. John, good to see you. Thanks for chiming in. Always fun on booze, right?
Absolutely.